Alright, Shalom. We're starting by giving all praise, honor, glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yavashai, Ba'ashem Haruka Kadash. Double honors to the apostles, you know, it was a great millstone. Peace and salutations to the whole elect. Coming at you with another lesson through the spirit power of Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yavashai. Lord willing, this lesson may be edifying. I want to start out the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 15. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. Redeeming the time, because the days are evil. We're in that time where we're about to see all hell break loose. Calamity, famine, rebellion, sedition among men, iniquity upon iniquity, and all manners of chaos that you can think of. That's why we are to be circumspect. All right, as we are understanding what's going on in society and what the devil, Esau, Edom, is about to bring forth. Now, I want to call this the IG edition. Now, usually when I'm on social media, I always save a lot of different clips of a lot of different things. All right. So this is going to be an IG edition of various topics, and I'll pull up a video, random videos, however the spirit may fit, and I'll bring some scriptures out to these different videos. And what sparked my spirit was this first video I seen right here at the top in the left hand corner. We'll start with that first.
What? And this lady just told us, no cash. We can't even pay with cash at Walmart. I don't know what's going on. Something ain't right. They can't take cash?
Cash?
I can understand they couldn't take a card, but they can't take cash? That just don't sound right. And then the lady said, they ain't even got paid today. What's going on, America? What's going on?
Have we not been talking about this? Have we not been telling Jake that what's about to come? The MOTB that's written in the Bible? See, while everybody playing games, while people are not paying attention, what's going on? Well, you even got Israelites that's not teaching the severity of taking the MOTB when E is going to eventually make this thing mandatory, right? As he says, he causes all small and great, rich and poor, free and bond. But people are downplaying this major prophecy. We are seeing the digital setup of it because we're close. Meaning we're close to the end as well. Because all we're waiting on is the MOTB, right? The two major prophecies that is left, right? We know that one of the two major prophecies is the MARK of the beast and World War III, right? Those are the two major prophecies that we are seeing being set up right now as we speak. As nations are being gathered right now over there to the Middle East, as the river of Euphrates is drying up so kings of the earth can make a passage over there to what? To fight for Armageddon to be brought forth, which is biblical prophecy, right? But everybody is downplaying these different things that's going on earth, but the prophets.
This is how it's gonna be in the future. You're gonna come to the bank, right? Try to get your money out, right? And then it's gonna say, oh, no, we don't have that much.
You'll take the 500, the measly five.
And then it's gonna go, oh, no, never mind, you can't get that either. And then your money is trapped.
Well, it says you can only get 250. Can you try and get 250?
There we have it.
$250, that's what UBS Bank has. It doesn't matter if you have millions of dollars in the bank right now, bro. You can only withdraw $250 cash. That is the banking fraud, ladies and gentlemen. Print money out of thin air, buy all the assets, extract all the liquidity and the cash of the system, and introduce central bank digital currencies.
Give me my money! Where's my money, motherfucker?
see how they played it out? That's how the majority of the people are going to be. They're going to be banging. They're going to do, that's called a bank run. People are going to be trying to storm each and every bank, each and every ATM to try to pull their cash out. But guess what? They are not going to be able to do it. We are seeing a digital setup in society happening right before our eyes. And we're about to set up what? The CBDC, the central bank digital currency, right? Which eventually is going to transfer over to the MARK. This cash that you see is about to be gone. As you've seen what was being talked about in the first clip. All right? Now, let's get a scripture. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 13. Verse 16, it says, "And he caused all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a MARK in their right hand or in their foreheads, that what? That no man might buy or sell, save he that had the MARK, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name." So without having this MARK, you are not going to be able to participate in society, because that's what you're going to need, right? And eventually, they're about to have this digital ID set up for you, right? Where you're going to need to have this digital ID to have access points to everything. Everything, right? Because they want to be, like I say, we say Esau has a God complex. He wants to be the know-all, be-all, see-all. Right? But we are seeing that infrastructure being set up. Okay? Really, really, in my opinion, it's already done. They're just waiting to do the FF, the F-A-L-C-E, or Slakia, the F-A-L-S-E, F-L-A-G-S, right? To do the order at chaos, the order out of chaos, right? They create the chaos, right? And then they come in and they establish the order out of the chaos that they have created. I believe this is the only thing we're waiting for. Okay? For them to implement this and say, this is what we need to do, right? For to monitor people and to keep people safe and to know everybody's whereabouts and to know what everybody's doing and what they got going on, how they think, how they move, etc. Right? But see, this is where the society is leading to. All right? Let's go here. Now, like I said, it's going to be random. It's going to be random of clicking on different clips, all right, that I have saved. It's not in a particular order, but as I seen this first clip, I said, you know what? As I saved it, I said, let me just do an IG edition of saved videos or saved clips. Let's continue.
I'm calling out all the parents. If you're a parent and your child is in pre-K to elementary school to high school, I'm calling you out. The children today, I have never experienced, and I'm 22. Having to teach and work with you guys as children has been the most traumatic experience of my life. I teach five-year-olds ballet. Five-year-old girls ballet. I have a class of 10 students. They don't respect any authority. You ask them, can you stand in your designated spot? They're telling you no and shut up. They're throwing things at each other. They're throwing things at other people, other classmates. You say, can everybody sit in their spot? I don't want to. I'm not doing that. You don't get to tell me what to do. You're not my mom. You confront the parent. The parent tries to argue with you. I'm calling out all and fuss at you because you tried to reprimand and redirect their kid. I told a young little girl, please sit in your spot. You're not my mom. You don't tell me what to do. Okay. When her mom came to pick her up, I said, hey, your daughter's having a hard time following instructions. And 7 times today, I've had to redirect her to just sit in her spot. Well, clearly she didn't want to sit. And mind you, this is a mom. Clearly she didn't want to fucking sit right there. So, I mean, if she's telling you she don't want to do something, why keep asking her to do it? You know she's not going to do it. What world do we live in? Like, what in you guys' brain as a parent says, my kid not following any directions is a great thing. It's not that serious, and y'all don't have a right to tell her what to do. It's sad. It's sad. It's really, really sad. And another thing that's heart-wrenching is horrifying and fuss at you because you tried to reprimand, and it is horrifying. Your five-year-old daughters are asking to listen to Pound Town and Ski Yee. Your five-year-old daughters are asking, can we hear Pound Town? I'm playing them Princess Tiana ballet music. And they are asking me, can we hear Pound? I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. And I'm so scared for these little girls today because this is the most insane, insane agenda push I have ever seen in my life. We do freeze dance. You guys' daughters are twerking at five. Where's the parenting? Where's the boundary? It is horrifying. Your five-year-old daughters are asking to listen to Pound.
Horrible. Horrible. This is a young teacher, right, that's teaching ballet. And when she tries to reprimand her students, you know, to follow directions and their behavior of them not listening, you have the parent co-signing the children's behavior of what? Of disobedience. On top of that, she is mentioning how she is seeing our young women or the daughters, right? The babies, these are babies, okay? Of the children of Israel twerking at five, asking to listen to reprobate, perverse, lewd music. If you do have any idea who this young woman, Sexy Red, is, her lyrics are horrible. Despicable. Amongst a lot of other of these artists, right? Of the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American people, right? But this goes for man and woman. We have been seeing videos pop up lately of the children of our people, right? One of the latest videos with the other babies at a toddler party. Kids might have been 5 and 6, 7 with handguns, with their fathers and cousins and uncles, right? Or whoever those male figures that was behind them promoting it, right? Letting them play with actual real guns, right? And throwing money around like it was some damn Cash Money 1999, 2000 rap video. This is the type of behavior that our people are into right now. And see, she's a teacher, so she's seeing it firsthand. And we be seeing it, you know, by the way of, you know, the media, for YouTube and TikTok and Instagram and Facebook. We see it in that aspect. And she's frustrated, you know, and she's seeing of our people are through. But see, these are the same things that we are saying. But guess what? When we say it, we get crucified. You see? See, let's just get into you, man. Because it's frustrating, man. It's frustrating and it's vexing of the things that's going on in a society amongst our people. This is why the 2/3 of our people are going to be destroyed. No ifs, ands, buts about it. Right? Let's go to this. I'm not even going to play him on the screen. But look at this. Kim Kardashian covered the latest issue of GQ Men of the Year. How? She's not a man. How is she on the GQ Men of the Year? You saying there's not no handsome man of the children of Israel that can't be on this cover? But she's put on there. You see the madness that Babylon is pushing? The confusion? This is why this is called the land of confusion. Right? Babel, Babylon. That's what that's going into. This is that place here. Now let's listen to this madness that I seen.
Far from even making porn lit a requirement, but if you're asking what would I like to see done, I'd like to see pornography literacy be embedded and integrated in school environments, in middle school and high school. I would like to see parents unlearning all of the things that they have, you know, been conditioned to believe around gender and sexuality and bodies and agency, so that they can disrupt and be the generation of parents that creates and cultivates healthy, fully formed, fulfilled sexuality for their young people. And then those young people are getting sex ed so that they become, you know, parents or the older generation of leaders that are continuing that sex positivity. But that's a huge cultural shift, and that's a big ask.
Porn lit a requirement? You have absolutely got to be kidding me. If it was a man suggesting this, he'd be labeled a predator. So my question is, why doesn't she get the same?
Are you witnessing what is happening in this society? So when we talk about this place needs to be burned. Let's get the scripture. Because I'm starting to get frustrated. It's just going, just watching these videos over again. Let's get the book of 2nd. I believe it's 2nd Peter chapter 3. No. Yeah, 2nd Peter chapter 2. Verse 5 says, "And spare not the old world, but save Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in a flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly, and deliver just Lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked." And the elect are in the same mindset right now. We are vexed continually of the conversation of the wicked, meaning the speech and the actions of these people. Did you hear the madness that this woman just said? That what should be taught in a new curriculum of schools? Did you hear this madness? And that parents need to relearn? We need to relearn about sexuality. If you can't tell from the signs of the times, the things that's going on around the earth, the earthquakes, right? The famine, the pestilence, you know, the wars, the rumors of wars, as it said, earthquakes in diverse places. You know what I mean? The uproars of the people, just how people are conducting themselves this day. If you cannot tell we are in the end, I don't know what's wrong with you. Because it seems like every day you wake up, society is getting worse by the day. Right? So verse 7, it says, "And deliver just Lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked, for that righteous man dwelling among them, in seeing and hearing vexes righteous soul from day to day in their unlawful deeds." So we of the faith, right? We are vexed continually from day to day. And you're going to even have some women that's going to have a, you know, they're going to have a similar mindset of being vexed of these things that's going on as well. You know what I'm saying? You had women back then, okay, of the children of Israel that did not partake, you know, in the madness that was taking place. When you go back to in the time of the Greeks, you know, you had a lot of women that, you know, was still serving and honoring Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. And, you know, when I believe it was Antiochus, when he made a decree for the woman to get rid of the male child, or they told him not to circumcise the male child, if I'm not mistaken, they said, "The hell, what you talking about? We're going to follow what the Lord said, do." And as the male child is to be what? Circumcised the eighth day. But guess what happened to those women that
you know, follow the law of the Lord. They was punished for it. You see, so you are going to have some women that are going to take heed to the word of Yahweh Shem Yahushai. All right? So, let's go to the next one. Let's see this.
I let my trauma time travel. It's hard for me.
Not that.
I said, well, let's see what Chick-fil-A has.
Oh. I don't want to go into that.
Niggas wanna hit it with Megan. He heard I work it, die, roll it like a
Horrible.
I actually had this thing in high school where I would teach guys how to make out in a bathroom. So there'd be a line of guys waiting to make out with me. So I always had like that energy of trains like in me. Trains are my passion. I think it's a really empowering thing to do as a woman because you're all here. Yeah, they're all here for me. It's everything I say goes. Like there, no one goes over the line. It's only what exactly what I want to do. I think it's all women should do it.
I ain't gonna say. Oh boy. Okay, I think I played this in the last video. Let's look at this.
We really need to go ahead and do that. There are too many millionaires and billionaires that we have. We should have airlines, banks, grocery stores, transportation systems. What the hell are you waiting for? Oh, I'm nervous about. Nervous about what? It's 2023. What are you afraid of now? I don't get it. I'm really trying to figure this out. Just give me a reason. What's up? You put $1 million down, they put $10 million. Y'all put $20 million. But stop making excuses and stop not getting it done. Because those of us, if we did have it, yeah, we could make it happen, being strategic. But stop acting like we don't have it. That's my only thing. Don't act like, brother, you walking around here with a chain that's worth $1 million. You wearing $500,000 on your neck, $18 million on your wrist. And you telling me, Floyd.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
$18 million watch. It's crazy, right? Yeah. Just a watch. Okay. You could change a lot of lives with that, industry with that. Mm-hmm. It'll flip quick. $18 million. Yes.
Yeah, we need to debunk that. Because what are you putting in this little space that's worth $18 million? I need to know
why. Please research it, because it shocked me the way it shocked you. This, the point is, there is no reason. There is no logical reason.
Now I do. I do listen to this brother right here. His name is Reza Islam or something like that. Now, of course, he's going off because he's in, you know, he's in into Islam, and he's an Israelite, which converted to the Nation of Islam. But the point being is, you know, he's trying to figure out of why Jake, and we say it all the time, and he's just only talking about Floyd Mayweather alone, of why Jake have abundance of all these different things, but Jake can't seem to come together collectively, right? As a people, why? Because it's not meant for us to do that, right? And in the fact that, another point, Esau would not allow no shit like that to happen, right? He is the puppet master. Everyone else is just the puppets, and he's stringing people along. There's no way this devil is going to let our people build another Black Wall Street. That shit is out, right? And furthermore, the Lord ain't going to let that happen. Because Jake, this is not your rest. Let's go to the book of Baruch chapter. There's a particular scripture I'm looking for. So just bear with me. Let's see. Oh, I used to pray in scripture all the time. I forget what it is. But basically, it's a scripture that's going basically touching on how, you know, we were brought here. Let me see. Oh, boom, right here. The book of Baruch chapter 4, verse 6, it says, "Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because you moved the Most High to wrath, you were delivered unto the enemies." So a lot of Jake want to understand of, If God loved us, why would he put us in this position? Well, this is why. Okay, this is why. This is why we were sold to the nations. Why were we sold to the nations? Because what? We pissed the Most High off. We moved them to wrath. So what did he do to us? He delivered us into the enemies, which are these other nations. And we're currently under our enemy right now, Esau, Edom. All right? Verse 7 says, for you provoke him that made you by sacrificing unto devils and not to the Most High. For ye have forgotten your everlasting power that brought you up, and you have grieved Jerusalem that nourished you. Okay? And that's our homeland. Our homeland is Jerusalem. All right? This is where we ran from in 70 AD, okay, during the Roman persecution, okay? And we fled to the interiors of West Africa and places of Africa and to other lands, Europe, all right? But we were sold to the nations because we were disobedient unto the Lord, all right? We are not here in Babylon the Great to... to flourish, so to speak, right? This is why we weren't able to flourish for real, because this is our punishment. Babylon the Great is a punishment unto us. It's not a place of, supposed to be a place of safety or luxury. You know, and we're coming to a time where you're going to see furthermore of this place is not our rest. See, we in the truth know this is not our rest. But you people have no idea that this is not your rest. This is why you can't understand why you're being destroyed as this place is destroying us with a sword of destruction. You don't understand it. You're still scratching your head trying to figure out why. But we're telling you why. Of why these different things are happening to us as a whole. Why you have people like Floyd Mayweather with an 18, the devil will let this man buy an $18 million watch. But I guarantee if he was to say, I'm about to spend $18 million to make a black, a all black city, so to speak, right? Black and brown, however you wanna mention it, they gonna be like, hell no. Nah. Because see, what people don't understand is the money that they give them, you can't just spend it of how you want to spend it. No, they need to know of what you're using your money on. Think about it. Think about Jake, right? Of us running almost every single entertainment business, not running. Well, let me rephrase that. Of Jake, because really who owned the entertainment business is Esau, okay? The 1948ers. But Jake has popularized it, right? And had everyone intrigued by it. So they're the ones, that's making all this money and really making the 1948ers the real money. While they don't do nothing but sit on their ass and collect. It's just a new form of slavery. That's all it is. But Jake is still not able to come together with their money to say, let's build, let's cut Esau. No. He's not with that. Okay. Everything is tracked and traced, so to speak, on a physical aspect. Okay. For you got to make phone calls, when you do certain transactions or purchases. And they want to know what you're doing with that money. And best believe they're going to check on what you're doing with that money. Oh, you buying an $18 million watch? Go ahead, nigga. You trying to do a project for what? A black and brown community? Nah. Denied. You ain't getting no $18 million. You feel what I'm saying? But Jake don't understand this. Right? And we already talked about this money. This money about to be, this funny money about to be done away with. You can basically call it monopoly money. Let's, what else we want to go on? Oh, yeah. Hey, boom, low.
The red are the executives that are Jewish.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Remember, everyone deemed Kanye as the crazy man. But this, see, this is what the elites do to the people. They deem people crazy. Either they did deem them crazy so people won't accept what they're saying, or they unalive them, you know, make it seem as if it's an apparent suicide. Right? But let's play this. Salakia.
Are the executives that are Jewish at these companies. But this right here is a chart of Universal Studios, 20th Century Fox, ABC News, CBS, CBS News, Columbia Pictures, Warner Brothers, ESPN Sports, Fox News, Washington Post, Metro Goldwyn Mayer, MTV Music Television, Nickelodeon, USA Today, Wall Street Journal, Comedy Central, NBC Entertainment, Google, what else do we have? Disney, ABC Kids and Family, YouTube, Los Angeles Times, Discovery Network, Paramount Pictures, Facebook, Huffington Post, Yahoo, Marvel, Hulu, Cosmopolitan, Time, Touchstone, Associated Press.
You see that? And there's more. More, 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 more. Who owns everything? The 1948ers. Esau, Edom. Okay? When the scriptures talk about, you know, we have to go to this man for the want of all things, it literally means that. He owns all the resources. He owns everything where he can paint the narrative. And one of the narratives he's about to paint is we, being the Israelites on the street corners preaching his truth, as we're the bad guys. That's what he's about to finna do. Okay? But we're going to continue to trust in Yahweh Bashim El Shai, whom we believe and know is going to protect us. All right? Let's see if I got any more. See if I got any more. Ooh, wee. I got a lot. Look at this madness. I got a lot of stuff. Just random posts, clips. What's this?
Remember when we became African Americans, because I worked in the black marketing department at Coca-Cola, mm-hmm. where we were selling Coke to our people. And the vice president came in and said, okay, we are now African Americans. We were like, all righty, African. I heard this white woman was sitting next to me and she said to another white woman, they don't know who they are.
Wow.
That's what I said.
Mm.
And I'm going to take my wig off and I'll be honest, I did not know what to say to her.
Mm.
I didn't know what to say to her.
But in a way, it's kind of true though.
That's why I didn't know what to say.
Yeah.
But African American seems to be sticking now.
I just think we should just be human. How about that?
No. No.
I remember when we became...
No, we are the Israelites. See, the truth is coming out now, or been coming out, but it's really on another level now. People are understanding that we are the biblical Israelites. We are the biblical Jews that the Bible is speaking of. We're not colored. We're not black. We're not African Americans. Right? We're not Puerto Rican, we're not Mexicans, we're not Guatemalans, we're not Colombians, we're not Native Americans, we're not West Indians, right? We're not Haitians. No. We are the Hebrew Israelites, all right? Let's see if there's any more. Oh, man, look. Let's click on this one right here, because we mentioned how, you know, Jake be talking about this black wealth. You know, oh, let's build black wealth. Let's build black this, black that, black. Why would you want to try to build a kingdom, right, in this wicked society? Nah. We, as the hopeful elect, we going to wait for a new kingdom that is promised to us. We ain't building shit here. What's this? No, let's play this one.
That shit not a lake. Under it was a black community. Most of these lakes made the cover up ever. Y'all swimming in graveyards, gotta be losing. Seneca Village, a black town up in New York, where black people own LA property. They tore it down and put up Central Park. They was hating on us the whole time. What the fuck? Kyle illegal. Black
town in Alabama destroyed. Now it's Lake Martin, Susanna, another town under that lake. Those are black Wall Streets, we can never be great. Vanport, Oregon, another black town got flooded. Now wow. That shit Delta Park. Wow. Where's our reparations? What the hell? These crimes need a punishment worse than jail. Warren in Baltimore, Maryland, a community that was black ran. And guess what them niggas put over it? Goddamn damn. I know it's a black town under the Hoover. I know it's a black town under Lake Mead. I know it's a black town under all these goddamn lakes in the day, nigga, stoking our breed. Got my ancestors under the sea. Got my ancestors buried on trees. Where the fuck is my goddamn money? Y'all paying these taxes, but what about me?
You see, but see, Jake made a rap, a little comedy skit out of it. But what he was saying was actually true. He didn't even bring up Black Wall Street. He didn't even bring up Rosewood. Right, and all the different flourishing cities that Jake had, right, that the devil have took over. You see, he mentioned how a lot of these black flourishing cities was turned into what, lakes or dam, right, or whatever the hell Esau made, you know. That's what he did, right? And what you think he gonna do if you try to build and do the same thing as you done before? Esau's gonna do nothing but destroy it. What's this?
Look what's happened in the last 20, 23 years. A disgrace. I personally investigated the Oklahoma City bombing case. Huge cover-up. Jack Kennedy's assassination, huge cover-up. Bobby Kennedy's assassination, huge cover-up. World Trade Center, huge cover-up. Okay. Terrorism. They're using it as an excuse to take away our constitutional rights and our civil liberties. The Illuminati, Bilderberg, New World Order, globalists are the element behind this. It dovetails into the satanic movement, and this movement has infiltrated into our intelligence community, the once great FBI and the CIA.
People should not be afraid of their governments. Government should be afraid of their people.
You see? So when people mention a new Illuminati, y'all be trying to put Beyonce and Jay-Z and these different entertainment. No. They're not part of the left-hand side. They are puppets of the left-hand side pushing their agenda, but they are not whatsoever a part of that circle or that group or those family of banking people whatsoever. They don't come close. Even Bill, Devil Bill, you know, Mr. Gates, he's not even part of that top club. He's just a face. You know, there's plenty of faces. All right. So I think, do I want to do any more on this? Oh, yeah, let's play this last clip, right? Check this out.
Being friendly and being a friend, I think, are two different things. I think there are many...
Hold on. Let me get a scripture. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 10, it says, never trust thy enemy, for like as an iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. Though he humble himself and go crouching, yet take good heed and beware of him, and thou shalt be unto him as thou hast wiped a looking glass, and thou shalt know that his rust have not been altogether wiped away. Set him not by thee, lest when he have overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place. Neither let him sit at thy right hand, lest he seek to take thy seat. And thou hast at thy last remember my words and be pricked therewith. So we've been telling you, never, never, never trust thy enemy, and Esau Edom is an enemy. Now let's play this clip.
Being friendly and being a friend, I think, are two different things. I think there are many whites who act friendly toward Negroes. A fox acts friendly toward the lamb. And usually the fox is the one who ends up with the lamb chop on his plate. The wolf doesn't act friendly, and therefore the wolf has more difficulty in getting the lamb chopped in his plate.
I'd like to point out, though, that...
I say that because it is usually the... If you study the structure of the Negro community, economically, politically, civically, psychologically and otherwise, it's controlled by the white liberal, mm-hmm. who usually poses as the friend of the Negro, who actually differs from the white conservative in the same way that the fox differs from the wolf. Their appetite is the same. Their motives are the same. It's only their mannerisms and methods that differ.
So that concludes it of this IG edition. Lord willing, hope it was edifying. Till the next time, I want to say, Shalom.